Good evening, welcome to MTV Source. This is going to be a special half hour for two reasons. First reason, the videos will be above average on MTV. Second reason, they are picked by the Cardigans. Now, we did this, last time we did it was about 4 years ago. We're in a cafe in London, and you had to pick like 60 songs, and it took 4 hours. Do you remember that? Yeah. It was quite painful. Yeah. It was fun, but painful. This time, it's a little bit easier. It's just four songs. So, was it a democratic choice, or is this something you do so often that you have a ready list?
I think it's a little bit for everyone in these choices. I think we're all
You're happy.
Happy with the choices, yeah.
Is anyone discontent with the... No? No, you happy?
I'm cool.
Yeah, you're cool?
Yeah.
We start from the very beginning with Buggles and Video Killed the Radio Star. Did it? Did video really kill the radio star?
I think it did. Because about the time when music videos came, that's when radio started to be commercialized and actually losing quite a lot of the quality, in my opinion. Mm.
What else happened when, what else did the video do to the sort of music industry? What else
it changed? Made the visuals a lot more important, I guess. A lot more. I mean, people had to look cool even before videos, but after it, it's kind of necessary. You really can't do much without a music video, which is good and bad in certain cases. But it's yeah, new thing.
So, what do you think makes a really good video?
Good idea. Helps.
Good idea.
I think all four videos were picked are kind of different, as the viewer will notice after seeing this program, which we are about to start right now. So, I don't know. They had the qualities.
Different qualities. What do you think it's limiting, the way the video climate looks and the way the music industry works, do you think it's limiting with the censorship, this radio edits back and forth? How much that does that sort of limit your creativity
well,
as a band?
The last video we made for the song For What It's Worth, we were so sure that we did the sweetest and the nicest video we ever could. And still, it really got censored the first thing that happened.
But do you think, like, all the stuff that's, like, radio edits of songs and stuff like that, is that limiting for you as a band as well?
Yeah, really, I think. I mean, we, on this record, we've, not intentionally, but we made the songs a bit longer, or we sort of had every song go its own way and stuff.
We have a song that's 7 minutes, so we maybe should consider not making a single out of that.
No.
But Buggles did make a single, and here is Video Killed the Radio Star. Video Killed the Radio Star. Trevor Horn there, the singer of that band, you're saying that your husband has potentially worked with him or met him or something?
Yes, and I think we actually had him. We were interested in maybe recording at his studio or something for this record. We
never did. He's produced lots of stuff, like everything.
I think he was on that list of producers that we were looking at, you know, on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
And then because you didn't pick him, he now worked with Tattoo, the Russian girl duo.
Yeah.
He did that. Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. So, and I saw you getting a bit sort of seeing that keyboard.
Oh, I love it. I like that. Massive. No frontal keyboard, but two on the sides. Ooh. I want a microphone that goes like a
headset.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. Next pick is perhaps not a video man release, Neil Young, Harvest Moon. Whose pick was that?
That's one that everybody picked.
Yeah.
I think all of us. Really?
Yes.
Right, so Neil Young, which is your sort of favourite Neil Young period? Because he's had a few different
70s.
Faces.
70s.
70s stuff.
Yeah. But, I mean, this song is from a really good album that's from
92,
I think.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, but I guess it's similar to what he did in the 70s. That's why I like it, I think.
He's had a bit of a weak period in the 80s, maybe.
Yeah.
But he got.
But everybody had, so.
The whole world.
Yeah.
But he got sued by Geffen, did you know that? $3 million for making uncommercial and unrepresentative music.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah.
That's nice. This is nice from a record company to sue someone for making music. You haven't had that.
And
who is
the judge?
I don't know.
Who
it's
says
court,
so?
I think it's court order.
So is the court are going to be like.
Yeah, listen. It's excellent.
Wow.
Now, with Neil Young, I was going to say, yeah, when you record a new album, how much does the direction of that album is sort of influenced by the music you're listening to at the moment? How much does that come into play?
A lot.
Yeah, I think so.
Have you been listening to Neil Young a lot before this album?
Yeah, definitely.
It's a pretty good source of inspiration.
Yeah, but I mean, it can. It's very often it's about, you know, certain atmosphere or vibe, not always directly, you know, like a song or arrangement. It's more the vibe for me, at least, I think.
The feel of it.
Yeah.
It's a good feeling in this song.
Definitely.
Yeah, here is Neil Young with Harvest Moon.
Own, you know, qualities. And this is sort of a quality.
To jump up from a grave with a motorcycle, I think, is a great quality. You guys did Black Sabbath covers on both Emmerdale and First Man on the Moon. Would you consider doing Killed by Death as a cover? Or is the cover days in the past?
Start considering now.
I think we did Sabbath songs because they have a really... They are actually pretty, you know, pretty poppy songs, actually. The Motörhead songs are amazing, but I think if we would do them Cardigan style, there wouldn't be so much for us to add, kind of.
If I might add, it might be kitsch, and that's not really what we wanted to do, even though some people thought we did Black Sabbath just to make fun of it. It was a, you know, pure love thing, but it's nothing to add, like Nina says.
But also, when you did it on the first time, that was sort of before the really big heavy metal retro wave that's sort of now coming across. I think it was easier. But if you did it, I mean, it could do the same thing for Lemmy as you did with Ozzy. Because I truly believe that Cardigan is the reason why Ozzy's now in his prime. I think MTV just tagged along with this whole docu-soap thing. But, you know, when you did the Sabbath songs, I think that's what really elevated Ozzy back into the limelight.
So where's the cash?
Where's the cash?
I don't know.
Ozzy's got it.
Have you got the No Remorse album that this song is from? Apparently it came in limited edition with a leather cover.
I just got the gatefold thing, but just plain paper, so to speak. But I got that when I was like 14, so it's been worn out. But actually, what my actual favorite track is called Dirty Love, and that's a B-side of Ace of Spades. Okay. That's, I think, one of the best rock songs in the world, but that's not really known.
It's weird that it ended up as a B-side, because it is really good.
This is also a very good song, Killed by Death. I think we should have a look at that.
Yeah.
Here we go, this is Killed by Death. Marcus, the producer, actually told me that Lemmy was called Lemmy because he used to go around to people and say, can you lend me a fiver? Can you lend me a fiver? And then they could start calling me Lemmy. Mm. I don't know if it's true or not, but
it is
true. Mm. So we've got one more song to go. And it's Devo with Whip It. How come you choose that?
Why it's not? Good. It's really good. You said it yourself.
Why not? Yeah, it's true. Why not? The lyrics actually, I've never listened to them before, but when I saw it on your list, I listened to the lyrics, and it's actually quite political, apparently. It's about how American society always used violence as a solution for everything. Which you might not think when you see the video with them lots on their heads. But do you think politics and music mix, is it a good marriage?
I think definitely in certain cases. I also think that if it's not really, really all right, it can be quite embarrassing in certain cases too. So you really have to, you know, you really have to be ready to defend your cause for like your whole career. So I don't think I would ever, no matter how strong my opinions would get, I would be too scared of limiting myself kind of to a cause.
Have you got any songs that are sort of, because you wouldn't think that Whip It was a sort of political, have you got any songs that people probably wouldn't think are political, but actually there is an underlining sort of?
There might be some little tendencies here and there to be, but they're so well concealed that nobody would ever believe me if I said it was political.
So I wanted to ask you as well about your own videos. Have you got like a favorite of your own videos?
Mm. I have to say, even though we made, even though I'm really happy with the last one we did, every time I see my favorite game, I think it's unbelievable. I think it's a great video, and it's going to stand time.
Yeah.
It has, you know, been standing time so far. I think it's really, really cool.